What's going on, everybody? It's Dwayne here, and bringing in the horizon, I've dropped a new track called Kool-Aid. And if you've seen any of my other videos I've uploaded, basically I like to do tone recreations where I listen to a song and then try and work out how to play that tone using the Neural DSP Quad Cortex. So I thought, I heard this, and I was like, this would actually be a really cool tone to replicate as well. It's got like a more industrial feel to it, but very much sounds like it's rooted in like that typical EVH type sound. So we're going to play this just a little bit to kind of show the tone we're going to be creating. Part of this will be working out how to play it as well, but okay, it's a pretty basic riff, and then it changes. Oh. That's better. Okay, see, you get the point here. So we're going to be using our trusty Neural DSP Quad Cortex, and we're going to be using Cortex Control to try and work this tone out. So being a higher gain tone, one of the first things you should always do, well, I always do, is I usually put like an adaptive gate in there, this type of stuff. Simple gate works too. 30% noise reduction will be fine. Now, this type of sound is like the typical tube screamer type sound where you dial up the level to 10 and you take the overdrive down to 0. So it acts as a boost pedal. And then for the amp, I mean, I have this pinned. This is one of my favorite amps, the EVH3-5153. And we will modify those settings shortly, and then we're going to need a nice stereo cab as well. I always go for the Zilla, and I actually had that pinned as well, so, well, I thought I had this pinned. Strange, that was pinned. Anyway, so we've got dock amp, we've got a pedal. And we need to tune our guitar as well. So I'm in drop D on this. I've also got Fishman Fluence pickups in there, so that will naturally affect how the tone sounds. If you're using this and you don't, you probably want to use like a gain pedal or something like that, or mess around with the overdrive pedal as well. We might actually find that I might have to tone down the level on the overdrive. In fact, I might even do that now because I can hear it's quite driven because active pickups are quite, you know, they really do drive the amp a little bit harder. So sometimes with a tube screamer type pedal, you turn the volume down a little bit. So we're going to use a pitch shifter as well because I can hear this is definitely not drop D. No bands use drop D anymore. So with this, I'm actually going to put this down to like 6.8 or something. A little bit of nostalgia from the 2000s for you. But basically, what we've got here is a classic, you know, high gain amp, tube screamer pedal, and a cab and a noise gate. So that's essentially, we've just created 2000s metalcore. Congratulations. You may also, as you notice, I did have to reduce the level on the tube screamer pedal a bit because I have active pickups. Now, if you don't have active pickups, what you're going to do is you're going to want to put that level all the way up to 10, because you're going to need that extra drive for the amp. But as I said, active pickups do drive a little bit harder, so I had to taper that off. And you can still hear it's quite nice. Now, what we want to do here is we want to add a pitch shifter in. Oh, and 12 is way too much. My hunch is maybe we'll go down 4. So what we have here is we've gone down 4 semitones, and I can tell this sounds like it's in drop B maybe. Sounds very Parkway Drive, that. So before we go and try and get that sound and the tuning, I'm actually going to drop the gain down on this. So for these types of sounds, it sounds like there's a lot of gain in there, right? Usually there isn't. Usually the gain is a lot lower than you think. I can also hear that the presence needs to be dialed up as well. So we're going to do like 6.2 on there. Probably want some treble, and I'm actually not going to scoop the mid out. And sometimes I'll usually cut the bass back. I'm actually going to increase this to like 5.5. And let's just hear what we got. So we have a pretty meaty sounding tone now. I think that sounds pretty good. It's going to need a little bit of work, obviously, but we'll get there. So I've taken the liberty here also of, I've got a stem I've created of this song. I've removed the vocals. So we're just going to... going to go to the saturated part here. Sorry, this is the wrong one. This is the wrong stem. I've got it open in Reaper. My mistake. Okay, let's just give this a quick little listen. Sorry about that if it was a bit loud. I'm actually listening through headphones in my Quad Cortex, and my speakers are actually playing the sound because I can't split it when I'm recording. So it's like the riff sounds like. Now, I think I need to go down maybe 6 semitones. Sorry, up. I think I need to go up. I need to go -2. Why can't I get that on 2? So we've gone down 2 semitones from drop D. So what's that? Drop C. Is that drop C? That sounds pretty damn awesome already, I will admit. We haven't even done the EQ or... higher low pass filters or anything on that yet. I'm not going to play that again. We're going to go to the original track here, and we're going to go. Mm-hmm. first drop C, I'm pretty certain. Okay. I mean, I think that sounds pretty damn good. Maybe we could take the level down a little bit. Active pickups, remember? Is that's drop C, isn't it? Yeah, it's drop C. That's a thrice riff. That. Tell you what, the pitch shifter works really well, actually, when you're not going down too low. So, I'm getting sidetracked here. We've got a pretty decent sound. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add an equalizer in there. And I don't know if we really have to go and, like, make too dramatic of cuts on here. No. All right, so we've got some default settings on here. We may change, what's this, 250. That seems like quite an aggressive scoop, in my opinion. I'd be more inclined to do like about a drop of one and then around the 400 mark, maybe 450. Yeah, I'd say around about 1.5 Q size just to make it a little bit more sweeping. Nice tight sound, and then lastly we want to do a low pass. Maybe we'll do around the 10,000 mark. Now, let's do 5 as the, we're going to do 5 actually as the low pass. And what do we do? 10,000. And then where is, we need 4. So for 4, we need, I feel like we need to cut some high end out. Around about what? Around about that. Yeah, just kind of make it a little less fizzy. Just slightly. And maybe what we're going to do here, maybe we should try knocking back the mid on the amp just a little bit. They don't have a scooped mid sound, so we don't want to get into metalcore territory, but... Maybe we do want mids, actually. scoop the mids out completely, it'll be metalcore. Yeah, I feel like we got mids, hey. Just a little slight little dip there. Maybe drop the resonance down a little bit. Gets a bit fizzy. I reckon we can take the gain down a little bit too. 3.5 maybe. Okay, let's play from the start. Is that? Maybe we do want a little bit more gain in that, actually. Maybe we do want some gain. Maybe 4. A little bit of chug on there. Maybe we could even go. Let's try what happens when we go to 6. I still feel like that's a bit too much gain. So the thing I've noticed with this tone is there's a synth or something behind it. There's something that's driving the sound behind it. You can actually hear it in... Sorry, this might be a bit loud, but listen to this. It's actually, I can hear, when I hear the guitar, even the stem, even though the stem is not perfect, it sounds like... It's actually got some nice, rich, like, saturation about it. Back in metalcore territory again here, but I think the important thing to know with this song is that we're hearing quite a large soundscape here. Like, the guitars themselves, like, what makes a heavy tone heavy isn't more gain or volume. You know, that's the kind of 80s mentality of, like, wall of sound, you know, massive amount of cabinets, ACD style. Because, funnily enough, if you look at bands like ACDC, they never actually play with much gain at all. Like, they were a pretty low-gain band. And then I think you had people like Eddie Van Halen and stuff who were just cranking the crap out of their amps and stuff. And it was a different time. These days, things are a little bit more production-driven. So songs like this, I'm guessing Jordan Fish did the production. He, like, one of his tricks I've seen stems for Bringing the Horizon tracks previously, and he loves to use, like, bass and, like, layers upon layers of synths to make massive walls of sound. But the guitars themselves, like, they're not as heavy and big as you think. They're actually quite thin. So our sound here could even be a little too gainy for what the original sounds like. We don't obviously have access to that, but one thing I think I would like to do to kind of fill the sound out a little bit, and it's a really good trick, is to add in a delay. So you can add in like a simple delay. Mix of 50% is probably too much. You want it to be subtle, maybe 20, and turn the sync off and turn the trails off. We may have to put down that delay time. So let's go. Can hear it at the end there when it stops. It's very, very subtle. So a delay is a really cool trick to get your sound to kind of, it kind of, I don't know, I guess it's kind of doubling it up in a way a little bit. So you're kind of getting this stereo double guitar effect, because once again, in an actual recording, you're not hearing one guitar, you're hearing four upwards, you know, more than that. I've seen some bands do six of separate guitar tracks. And Bringing Me the Horizon, actually, funnily enough, with their sound, they do this really cool thing where they actually blend amps, and it's, you know, not an uncommon thing. A lot of producers will actually, like, blend different amps to get characteristics of one and then another, and then it's all about the percentage split. So you may have one amp that has kind of like a nice sort of mid-range and aggressive bite. Then you might put another amp in underneath, like a JCM 800, for example, and you may actually, like, scoop the mids on that quite a bit so you don't overpower the other amp, and then add in a little bit more, like, grit and dirt in there. I haven't actually gone down that path too much myself with the Quad Cortex in terms of, like, combining amps. I have done it a few times, but generally the Quad Cortex is really good at letting you get a massive sound that you can sculpt without kind of having to combine amps too much. But it is another cool little trick to kind of get a sound if you can't get that out of the stock amps. And obviously another little trick as well is to use IRs with your cabinets as opposed to just using the stock ones. Don't get me wrong, I think the stock ones are really good, but some IRs out there, like the downtuned ones, are really, really good. Highly recommend the Bogren Digital ones, the downtuned one. They got a downtuned pack. And there's also the Buster Odorhome Audio IRs as well, which are really, really good. And in future videos, I may do something with those. I try and avoid using captures and third-party IRs and stuff. I want these to be accessible to everybody without having to do any extra work. So I think we've got a pretty good end result here. We're just going to save this now. And what are we going to call it? Kool-Aid. So this will be uploaded to the cloud. By the time you're watching this video, it'll be on there. I'll be linking it in the description. But I think this is actually a really, really good tone. Like, it's not a super complicated sound. And we probably didn't even need to use EQ. We could have got away with, like, just, you know, using the stock amp and cabs and stuff, and it still would have sounded good. But let's try and play through. I'm gonna have to have one ear off because I'm listening through speakers. It may not be completely in sync, and I don't actually really know how to play this song yet. This is kind of like, you know, my first real listen to the song as well, so let's have a quick little play. I'm probably going to get copy strike from this, but the video shouldn't be taken down, hopefully. But that's just what happens with these tone creation videos. So let's go. It's like, kind of like a squeal. Oh, I can't do it. There we go. So, I think that got really close, to be honest with you. Like, it's not like spot on recreation, because as I said, like, and as I always say, I'm like a broken record in that regard. It's kind of impossible to get the same tone as an album tone, because album tone, live, like, you hear them play the song live, it won't sound the same. Like, they'll still have the same backing tracks and stuff, but there's always a subtle difference because production trickery kind of adds stuff on. But that's really, really close. I'm really happy with that. And that'd apply well. It's like a metalcore tone, basically. You know, this would probably apply to an album like Sempiternal or something. I would be willing to wager. I don't really know any songs with that album either, but yeah, really cool, solid tone. I'd probably use this for metalcore stuff as well. But I've got enough metalcore presets, so probably not. But yeah, if you enjoyed watching this video, let me know how you think I did as well, because I'm not a recording engineer, I'm not really a great guitarist, but I like to have fun and I like to show people how to get tones on the quad cortex. So let me know in the comments what you think could have been done better, if you have some suggestions. If you have songs that you want me to try, let me know in the comments as well, and I'll gladly open to suggestions. And I'll see you in the next video, and thank you for watching.